So, what is bean packing problem? First, we have to understand that what does it mean? What do you understand by bean packing problem, and why this algorithm is used? So, we have discussed one very common algorithm, knapsack problem. So we have discussed fractional knapsack as it belongs to greedy approach. We can solve the problem using greedy approach. We have not discussed 0-1 knapsack yet. We will discuss it in dynamic programming. In dynamic programming, few topics will be discussed. So let us start this bean packing problem and what actually it means. We know that in case of knapsack problem, if we talk about the very well known problem, which is knapsack problem. What is knapsack problem? So if a knapsack is given, okay, so in this case a knapsack or
excuse me sir,
yeah
sir, can you please write bigger sir, it's not clearly visible.
Okay, say is it visible now?
Yes, sir.
So a knapsack is given. And its size is, say, the size of the knapsack is say it's M. Size of the knapsack is M. Now some items are given. Some items are given, and for these items they are associated with profit and weight. Okay, so basically this size is in terms of weight. And the items are given, for which item profit and weight are given. Now if we want to select the items, we have to select the items in such a way so that we can maximize the profit. So here basically the objective is to maximize the profit. So our objective is to maximize the profit. Now if we want to maximize the profit, we know that in knapsack problem we are sorting the items as per profit per weight. So as per profit per unit weight, then one by one items are being selected for the knapsack until the knapsack is full. So using this greedy approach we can get the optimal solution. Okay, so the solution which we will get, that is the optimal solution. There is no such scenario that we can get more profit in some different combination. So optimality can be achieved in knapsack problem. Now in case of knapsack, there is a single knapsack. We have only one knapsack and some items are given which are to be selected for the knapsack. In case of bean packing problem, okay, so what is bean packing problem? Bean packing problem is little bit different. So if we talk about the bean packing problem, so bean packing problem is basically some items are given. So in this case, some items are given. Now you have to allocate those items. So objective is basically allocating the items in such a way that number of bin is minimum. So in case of knapsack problem, we have only one knapsack. In case of bin packing problem, number of knapsack or bin is more than one. So some items are given, you have to allocate the items in those bins so that you can get maximum, you can allocate all the items in using minimum number of bins. So this is the main objective of bin packing problem. In case of knapsack problem, we have taken different example, like the algorithm we choose or use during shopping. But in case of bin packing problem, why these algorithms are used? So basically, bin packing problem is used in transportation system, in many cases of transportation system. Say that we have one warehouse at Ruby, we have another warehouse at Rajarhat. Okay. So from one warehouse, if we want to transport a significant number of items from Ruby to Rajarhat, then we have to load some trucks. Okay. We have to load some trucks so that we can move these items from one warehouse to another warehouse. So when we are allocating, we are just going to load this truck, then obviously the objective is we have to minimize number of trucks. So if you can allocate the items or load the trucks in such a way that using minimum number of trucks, you can ship those items from one position to another position, then it will be beneficial, because based on number of trucks or vehicles, you will be charged. Okay. So bill will be generated based on number of trucks. So if we can reduce number of trucks during this transportation, then we can minimize our basically the expenditure or cost. Okay. So this is the main objective of bin packing problem. So bin packing problem is completely different compared to knapsack problem. In knapsack problem, objective is we have a bag, so we have to maximize the profit. So we have to select the items in such a way that we can maximize the profit. But in case of bin packing problem, we have to select all the items. Just 1 minute, please. Hello. আচ্ছা, আর্জেন্ট কিছু না, একটু পরে কথা বললে হবে। আচ্ছা ঠিক আছে, আমাকে তাহলে একটার দিকে কল করো, আমি এখন ক্লাসে আছি। হ্যাঁ। সো হিয়ার, সো লেট আস ট্রাই উইথ ওয়ান এক্সাম্পল দ্যাট হাউ ইট উইল বি অ্যালোকেটেড। So bin packing problem is little bit hard problem in terms of complexity analysis, because this problem belongs to NP hard category. We don't have any polynomial time solution for this bin packing problem still yet. If any one of you can prove that this algorithm, you can design one algorithm that by which the bin packing problem can be solved using polynomial time algorithm, then it will be a huge achievement. So it's an open problem. You may think, you may design one algorithm, but till date, no one is able to design any polynomial time algorithm for solving this problem. Okay. So there are lots of problems which are still date, which are open challenge. So anyone may try to solve the problem. So we have hundreds of open problem. So just previously, just for your kind information, that in 2016, one student from IIT Kharagpur has solved an NP-hard problem in polynomial time. And that's a huge benefit, because later on in this paper, we will discuss that how one problem is being mapped with other problem. So if we can solve a problem using polynomial time algorithm, which still date is not solvable in polynomial time, that will help in huge optimization, because many problems by that algorithm, many problems can be solved in polynomial time, so which is infeasible in real time, that becomes feasible in real time. So you may think of the problem and you may try to design any algorithm by which it can be solved in polynomial time. Okay, so if you can do, obviously that's a great benefit. So in computer science, in terms of complexity analysis. Okay, so let us try to understand what happened. I'm giving you, for better visualization, I'm giving you one example. Say I have a bin. Okay, so this is bin 1. I have another bin here. I have three bin having same capacity. Okay. Now, let us try to put some items. So for this bin, say the capacity is 4x4. Okay, for all of this bin, their capacity is 4x4. Now I have few blocks of wood. So I want to allocate these blocks in such a way so that using minimum number of bin, they can be allocated. Okay, so say I have a block 3x3. Okay, sorry, I have a block 3x3. This is a block. Now let us consider some other block. So some items are given. So one block is given, it's 3x3. And then next one is three by one. Then 2x1, then 3x1, just give me 1 minute. I will create a problem scenario. 3x3, 3x1, 2x1, 3x1, Okay, let us take some more blocks will be added here. Okay, so if I have this block, then I have chosen this first block. Okay, so these are the bins. Now I have chosen block 1, block 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. In that way, some blocks are given. So I have chosen this first block 3, 3 here. Now the next block is 3, 1. Okay, where I can put this block 3, 1? I can put it here. It's a 3, 1. This is a block which I have kept here. Okay, now the next block is 2, 1. Okay, third block is 2, 1. So I can allocate it here, 2, 1. Then I have 3, 1. So 3, 1 cannot be allocated here. Okay, so I can allocate 3, 1 here. This one is 3, 1. Then 3, 1. Also, up to this, we have allocated up to this 3, 1. Now, say the next block is 1, 1. Okay, next block is 1, 1. Now, if the next block is 1, 1, we may allocate it here 1, 1. Okay, now the next block is 2, 1. Okay, so instead of 3, 3, next block is 2, 1. Okay, or just let me erase this. Let us consider the previous case. So the next block is 3, 3. So if the next block is 3, 3, we can allocate it here. This is 3, 3, and the next block is 2, 1. Okay, so if the next block is 2, 1, so we can allocate it here, 2, 1. And say I have another block, 8th block, 3, 1. Okay, so where I have to allocate it, 3, 1? I can't allocate it in bin 1 because we don't have sufficient space. In bin 2, we can't allocate it. So where I have to allocate? I have to choose another bin. So if I choose another bin, then this one is 3, 1. Okay, now how many bins are required? In this case, how many bins are required?
3. 3.
Okay. Now, is there any better way to solve it? Do you feel that we can allocate these blocks in 2 bins only?
Yes, sir, it can be. Yeah, it can be. Sir, how? Bin 1 is 2 cross 1, ache otake bin 2 te diye dile okhane 3 cross 1 er jaygata to pore ache tale shekhane bin 3 ta ke na di ota bin 1 e diye dewa chole. Yeah, so we have found one problem scenario where if we apply greedy approach. So greedy approach means the blocks are given.
We are choosing one by one block. Now, I will choose first block, then second block, then third block. In that way, I will proceed. So when I'm choosing one by one block, I'm trying to place it in bin. Okay? So in greedy approach, I have solved the problem. So when I'm applying greedy approach, then we have come to a scenario. here we have come to a scenario where at least three bins are required. We have some free space in previous bin, but we can't utilize this free space. Okay, the problem is due to allocation algorithm. So how it can be solved? This algorithm can be solved using dynamic programming. Okay, and in that case, the complexity of this problem is basically exponential. We don't have any polynomial time algorithm to solve this problem. So the complexity of this time becomes exponential. We will discuss it later. So if we think of different combination of these bins, then we will find one optimal solution. So if blocks are given, if the m number of blocks are given, say I am considering that if m number of blocks are given, so m is number of blocks and n is number of bin. Okay, so you have to allocate these blocks into these bins in such a way that there is minimum number of, within minimum number of bin we can allocate these items. So how this problem will be resolved? So if the problem is, instead of this, if the given sequences, let me choose a different color. In this given sequence, say first block is 3x3, then second block is again 3x3, then 3x1, then 3x1, then whether it's a 1x1, then say it 2x1, 1, 2, 3, 4. We have chosen this one, 3, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 1, 1, 3, 3. Remaining is 2, 1 and 3, 1. So another 2, 1 and another 3, 1. Okay. If the given sequence is this, then you will find optimal solution. Let us prove that if the given sequence is this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and this is 6, 7, and 8 block. So if this is true, so in first bin, so let us choose. So I have two bins. Let us check whether it can be fitted there or not. Sorry, sir. The first block is 3, 3. So let me allocate 3, 3 here. Let me allocate 3, 3. Then what will be the next item? The next item is after 3, 3. Now the next item is, so we have allocated this, then next item is 3, 3 again. So 3, 3 can be fitted here. So 3, 3, this one is 3, 3. Then we have 3, 1. Say this one is 3, 1. We have allocated this one. Then 3, 1 again. If the next one is 3, 1, I'm allocating it here. 3, 1. Then 1, 1, 1, 1 will fit here. Then 2, 1, 2, 1, and 3, 1. So say this one is 2, 1. This is 2, 1, and this is 3, 1. So how this problem is being solved? So if we get this sequence of blocks, then it can be solved. Is it fine? So if we get a sequence that can be fitted, so what we have to do if we want to solve the problem. If the objective is we have to minimize number of bin, then objective is basically if m number of blocks are given, so just okay, so here basically if m number of blocks are given, so if m number of blocks are given, then how to solve this problem? We have to rearrange the blocks in such a way so that we can test all the possible combinations. So if m number of blocks are given, then how many possible arrangement can be done using this m block? Factorial of m, that is the number of
possible sequence. You know that?
Is it fine?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So if we have m number of blocks, then factorial of m number of possible rearrangement can be done. Now we have to test each and every rearrangement. Now for certain rearrangement, we will get the optimal solution.
So basically, when a set of blocks are given, then if we want to allocate it into bins, then there is no specific guideline. So we have to think of all the possible arrangement of the blocks. Then we have to choose one by one block. Now in certain cases, number of bin will be minimum. For which case the number of bin is minimum, that is the optimal solution. Okay. Now if you have m number of blocks and if you want to calculate, if you want to check it, for factorial of m sequence, can you imagine the value of factorial of m? If I have 100 items in a warehouse, okay, I have 100 items and I have to transport these 100 items from one location to another location. So how many trucks are required? So for 100 items, so m equals to 100 here. If m equals to 100, then possible rearrangement is, what will be the possible rearrangement? 100. So that means it's a factorial of 100. Can you imagine the value of factorial of 100? You can't calculate it using calculator. That is the total number of possible sequence. Now from that sequence, you have to find the solution. So it's an exponential time problem. Its complexity is very, very high. So that's why this bin packing problem needs to be solved using dynamic programming. So we'll come to that later. So do you understand the problem scenario, why bin packing problem cannot be solved using greedy approach? Because in greedy approach, we can choose one by one block and we can try to place it in appropriate bin. So it results in a scenario where in some bins which are already in use, there are some vacant spaces. but still we can't utilize these vacant spaces because the next item which is arriving or we have in this list, that item doesn't fit in this vacant spaces. So how this we will decide at runtime that which item needs to be shifted from one bin to another bin, how this decision will be taken? So to take this decision, this algorithm becomes NP-hard problem. And if it's a NP-hard problem, we don't have real life solution. Okay, so in that case, to get the optimal solution, we have to choose one exponential time algorithm. Otherwise, we have to come to a conclusion that we have to apply approximation algorithm, which will not ensure that this is the optimal solution, but it will try to reduce. Sometimes it may give you optimal solution, but we can't, it will never be ensured that this approximation algorithm will give you optimal solution. Okay, for bin packing problem, according to your syllabus, the concept is needed, but basically the dynamic programming and the solution or algorithmic approach is not included in your syllabus. Only the concept is needed. Okay, so this is the scenario. So let us understand the problem mathematically. Okay, so for mathematical formulation, we will discuss it one dimensional problem because it will be easier to understand. Any query?
Sir, hello.
Yes.
স্যার বলছি রিয়েল লাইফ প্রবলেমে তো ওই ট্রাকের যে প্রবলেমটা বললেন তো ওখানে তো স্যার স্পেসটা তো অলওয়েজ 3D চুজ করতে হয় তো সেক্ষেত্রে এম ফ্যাক্টোরিয়াল তো মানে টাইম কমপ্লেক্সিটি কি এম ফ্যাক্টোরিয়ালই হবে কারণ তো মানে দুটো ডাইমেনশন সেম হলে আর একটা ডাইমেনশনে ডিফার করলে তো তাদের মধ্যে একটা আলাদা কম্বিনেশনস হতে পারে
ইফ ইটস আ 3 ডাইমেনশনাল ইন দ্যাট কেস ইট উইল বি মাচ মোর কমপ্লেক্স অবভিয়াসলি দ্য সিনারিও ইজ ইন দ্যাট কেস ইউ হ্যাভ টু ইউজ three dimension. In case of three dimensional, the problem is much more complex. We have just discussed with two dimension, but now we will discuss with one dimension only. Even in one dimensional case, you will understand that in case of even one dimension, the problem is NP-hard problem. Now it if it becomes two dimensional or three dimensional, the complexity of the algorithm becomes much more harder. But all of them belongs to exponential time algorithm category, so they belongs to NP-hard category. Is it the question?
Yes, sir. Okay.
So let us discuss with one dimensional problem. Say capacity of the knapsack is C. Capacity of the bin is C. C is the capacity of each and every bin. Okay. Now, I have some items. Say items, ith item is what should I use, which symbol? Say item is a set of I. So this is first item, second item, third item. In that way, I have m number of items. Okay, m number of items are given, and C is capacity of each and every bin. So say weight of the item is, for each and weight of the item is basically, the weight of the first item is W1, then W2, W3. In that way, WM. These are the weights of the items, and capacity of the bin is C. Again, this is in terms of weight. This is in terms of weight. Now, how this problem will be solved? So I am considering that x ij is the allocation vector. This is allocation matrix. Okay, this is allocation matrix. So if this is the allocation matrix, how the problem will be solved? So I'm checking whether here I represent I represent ith item, and j represents jth container. Jth bin. Okay, so how this matrix will be represented? So say this is the matrix, allocation matrix xij. Okay, so xij is basically a binary matrix. This one is basically a binary variable. Okay, this one is binary variable. Why it's binary? The value of xij can be 0 or 1. So xij will be 0. Sorry, I will write 1 if ith item is allocated in jth bin. If ith item is allocated in jth bin, then the value of xij is 1. And if the ith item is not allocated in jth bin, then the value is 0. So 0 is otherwise. So we are defining xij in that way. So it's an allocation matrix. So in case of this allocation matrix, so how the things are being allocated? So this is a matrix. So m number of items are given and n number of bins. So this is the allocation matrix. So m is the number of item. So here m number of item. So starting from 1, 2, 3, in that way, the last index is m. And here it will be 1, 2, up to n. N number of bin is given. Okay, so this is the matrix. Now, if first item has been allocated to bin 1, then this value is 1. If ith item is allocated to jth bin, then the value that cell will be 1. Okay, so which are not allocated in which bin, for those cases, that cell will be 0. That's why we have written that if ith item is allocated in jth bin, then this value is 1, then xij is 1. If ith item is not allocated in jth bin, in that case, that value is 0. Okay? So this is the matrix representation. So now this xij becomes allocation matrix, which clearly depicts that this item is allocated to this bin. Okay? Do you have any confusion up to this?
No, sir.
Is it no for everyone or
yes,
only sir. Yes. No, sir.
No, sir. Okay, okay. If you have any doubt, then please tell me. This is just the starting point of NP hard problem. Now, from the next week, we will discuss some problems which will be very hard to understand. And when we will discuss the last chapter, intractability. Basically, this is the module which is very hard to understand. This is one module, a complete module according to your syllabus. This is the toughest chapter in your career, I can tell you. This one is the toughest chapter if we consider even all the papers which you will learn in undergraduation or even in post-graduation if you are taking admission in PG. This is the toughest chapter you have to face. Okay. Okay. Let us try. Okay. We are returning back here. So this is the allocation matrix. Now, if this is the allocation matrix, what is our objective? Our objective is to minimize number of bin. Okay. Now, when we are trying to minimize number of bin, then what can I write here? So, let us try to define the problem. Here, let us say that xij is the allocation matrix. Now, if an item which has been represented by capital I, if that item, ith item, is allocated, this ith item is allocated in xij. Okay, if the ith item is allocated, just a minute, sorry. Hello. Ma'am, আমি পরে কথা বলছি, আমি এখন একটু ক্লাসে আছি. So, if this is the ith item, if this ith item is allocated in xij, in jth container, then the value is xij. So, xij multiplied by weight of I, this value must be less than equals to capacity of the container. So this is a constraint. Okay, so we have to define the objective function, but the objective function needs to be solved subject to the following constraint. Subject to the following constraint. what is the constraint one? So constraint one is basically the xij multiplied by wi, this one needs to be less than equals to c. Let me write the constraint again. So, as we have pointed, so basically, what will be the constraint one? As we have written, x I j multiplied by w I, this value should be less than equals to capacity of the bin, because we can't select the items which will exceed the capacity of a bin. So it should be less than capacity of the bin. Now whatever items will be allocated in this bin, their sum of their weights should be less than this. So the constraint is, we can finalize the constraint as sum over I. Okay, so sum over I, you know that here we can also write I equals to 1 to m, or instead of this we can just write sum over I. So sum over I x of ij into wi should be less than equals to capacity of the bin. So we will allocate the items in this bin in such a way that this one is, this condition is satisfied. So this is one of the important constraint. Okay, so if say I have 10 items and 5 bins, I have 10 items, so for each and every item, for all the values of I, so x, and we are considering for say bin 1, okay, bin 1, so what will be the value? X 1 1 multiplied by w 1 plus x 1 sorry 2 1 multiplied by w 2 plus x 3 1 multiplied by w 3. So this summation should be less than equals to c, capacity of the bin. Okay, it should be less than equals to capacity of the bin. Now for those items which are not allocated in this bin, for those items xij becomes 0. So then 0 will be multiplied with wi. So for that item, the whole thing is 0. If the whole thing is 0 for that item, then obviously that weight is not contributing in capacity comparison. So this is the first constraint. What will be the second constraint? The second constraint is,
so this is for one bin or all the bins?
For all the bins.
Okay.
This is for all the bins. Okay. So basically, okay. So just to formalize it, we can, just for understanding, I can write this is for Cj. So Cj is the capacity of jth bin. In our case, for all the bins, capacity is same. Okay. So for all the bins, yes, capacity is same. Now, if we consider the next part means, what will be the another constraint? If we think of a row, so ith item, so this row represents ith item. Am I right? This row, one row represents ith item. Okay. So these cells are representing allocation of ith item in any bin. So only one item will be allocated in only one bin. We can't allocate one item in multiple bin. Is it fine? So if only one item is being allocated in only one bin, so the another constraint is sum of x ij, sum of x ij, this value, oh my god, So sum of xij over j, this value should be equals 1. Okay, so in a row, if we consider this, in a row only at one position the value can be 1. If we consider a row, so in a row at only one position this value can be 1. Otherwise, if the value is 1, so if in a row twice the value is 1, so that means x ith item is allocated in container or bin, some bin, say bin 3 and bin 5. It's not possible. So only once it will be allocated. So we can write it as this constraint. So constraint 2 is basically sum over j, xij, this one should be 1. Okay. You can also write it that sum over j, that means you can also write that j equals to 1 to n, this sum will be 1. So these two are the constraints. Okay. These two are the constraints based on which the allocation will be done, that which item will be allocated in which container or bin. Okay. Now, what will be our objective? So let us define the objective function. So how it will be the objective? So if I write the objective function here, our objective is minimize, I have to minimize, say, say bins in use. So bins in use, say, let us represent u, j. How many bins are there? N number of bin. So u, j represents whether this bin is in use or not. So if at least one item is allocated in this bin, then the bin is in use. Even if we load one item in a truck, then truck needs to be migrated from one position to another position. So truck will be in use. So if in a truck at least one item is allocated, the truck is in use. Similarly, in a bin, if at least one item is allocated, then it is in use. Okay. So we have to minimize sum of uj. Okay. So sum of uj over j. So if we calculate sum of uj, this value needs to be minimized. Okay. Then what will be the relation between uj and xij? So the relation between uj and xij is uij is again a binary variable. Uj is binary variable because the value can be either 0 or 1. The bin is in use or not. So it's a binary variable. So how this uj is defined? So uj equals to 1 if at least one item is allocated to it, okay, or otherwise the value will be 0. Okay. Now what will be the relation? There must have a relation between uj and xij. Okay. So what will be the relation? But just for simplifying it, I'm saying that what will be the value of uj? Uj is basically one if sum of xij is greater than equals to 1. So in a container, if in jet container at least one item is allocated. In jet container at least one item is allocated, this value must be greater than equals to 1. And in other case, this value is 0. Okay, so this is the relationship between uj and xij. Now the problem can be solved using integer linear programming, but the things are not included in your syllabus, so we are not going to solve that problem. So in that case, this relationship uj and xij needs to be built in different ways. But for simplifying the problem, we are discussing that this is the relationship between uj and xij. So that's all about bin packing problem according to your syllabus.
Sir, ekhan theke ki tale shudhu theoretical question ashbe?
Yeah, it will be theoretical.
Linear programming je solve korle ki ta exponential time I ashbe?
Obviously.
Time bomb list.
Obviously, it's an exponential time problem. Even still now, we have not formulated the integer linear programming here. In that case, the third constraint needs to be built in different way. Okay, but the problem is exponential time problem, obviously. It will be solved using simplex method. Have you learned simplex method?
No sir, I have just learned to solve the x values and y values from my equations, basically matrix manipulations time like.
Okay, so I don't know whether according to your syllabus do you have the paper operation research, which is I don't know in new syllabus whether it's there or not, but this one is very important paper, whether it is included in your curriculum or not, but this is one of the important paper everyone should know in computer science and IT, because there are different approaches by which different problems can be solved. Okay. If you get time, try to read two papers, basically two subjects. This is for everyone. Try to read two subjects. One is statistics, and if you have time, then operation research. If it is included in your syllabus, then it's fine. It will be covered in one semester. But if it's not included in your syllabus, then try to read it by yourself. And another paper which is not related to the theoretical or mathematical formulation, but the name of this book is Design Patterns. Design pattern is very important to design and write any program. I would suggest you to familiar with the design pattern. This is a paper, you can just Google it, that you can search by the string Gang of Four. The four authors are named as, they are well known as Gang of Four. Gang of Four. So this four person, they have started, they have coined the term design pattern. So this is very important thing. If you want to be a developer, you want to be a designer, obviously. In computer science, your objective is to be an architect or to be a software developer. So if you want to be an architect or even a software developer, if you know the design pattern, not all the pattern, at least if you have clear idea about 20 different design patterns, then it will be, your life will be easy to solve any problem. You can design any software if you know that. The things are again some approach. It's not just syntaxes of a programming language. It's an approach. Whether you are using C, Java, C++, Python, whatever programming language you prefer, this is an approach. Okay, how you will solve or deal with a specific or special type of problem. If we have special scenarios which are very complex, how to write program, it will help you to understand that. But the problem is, in India, in most of the universities, these papers are not covered. I don't know why. This paper is from last year. It has been in Calcutta University. They have included this paper in syllabus. But I have not seen this paper in any other university or institute. But this is very important paper. As a paper or as a subject, this is a concept which everyone should know. Even the people who are working in industry 10 years, many of them are not familiar with design pattern. But without knowing it, sometimes they are applying design pattern to solve a problem. But if you know design pattern properly, you can solve a problem very easily. If I give you any problem, you can easily map that using this design pattern, this problem can be solved. Okay. So try to keep this thing in your mind. If you have leisure time, try to spend some time with this paper so that it will help you to build your career. Okay. You are too busy with phone and other stuff, but at our time, probably, as we had only basic phone, then without sending SMS, we can't use it at this extent as for now. Just a minute. So, hello, sir. মানে আমি একটা জিনিস বুঝতে পারছি না, মানে এরা কি নতুন করে কম্পিউটার সায়েন্সকে ডিফাইন করবে? ও প্রোগ্রাম লিখলো, সেভ করলো, সেখানে ডেটাবেসে সেভ হলো না, এটা কি মানে এই গল্পগুলো দেবে আর শুনতে হবে? এগুলো ধরতে হবে, মানে প্রবলেমগুলো একই জায়গাতে। অঙ্কিতা সে দিনের পর দিন বলে যাবে সে ক্লাস অ্যাটেন্ড করেছে, অথচ তার ক্লাসের অ্যাটেন্ডেন্স লিস্টে তার কোথাও তার নামের ট্রেস নেই। এই প্রবলেমগুলোকে এবার ডিল করতে হবে। ঠিক আছে, দেখছি। হ্যাঁ ঠিক আছে স্যার, হ্যাঁ ঠিক আছে স্যার, আড়াইটি। ঠিক ওকে। সরি ফর দ্য ইন্টারাপশন। দিস ইজ দ্য কেস। ওকে, সো ট্রাই টু understand that if you want to be a computer professional, try to learn something, because it will help you a lot. The online mode is quite difficult. I have nothing to say more, because we can't track every one of you. If you are in classroom, then we can understand it by your face, but here we can't see your face, so it's difficult to understand that whether you are able to understand or not. But these are things I will suggest you to read. Okay. Now I'm coming back here. stresses. Okay. So let us start the another problem. This previously it was in your syllabus, but it has been removed from your syllabus. But still, we are saying that this one is very important algorithm, and without discussing this algorithm, we can't discuss our next topic. Next topic means this longest common subsequence. We can't discuss this algorithm without understanding the KMP algorithm. Okay, so here we are trying to discuss KMP algorithm first, then we will come to our next topic. Okay. So we will start this topic, longest common subsequence. So before that, let us try to understand what is KMP. So what's the problem? The problem is basically, if a string is given, okay, say add two strings. So this is string one, and I have another string. It's string 2. So you have to find, so your objective is you have to find whether string 1 is present in string 2 or not. In string 2 or not. Okay. So this is the objective of the algorithm. You have to check whether this string 1 is present in string 2 or not. How will you solve the problem? So you have to find the string in another string. So if I ask that, what do you think? That this problem is not a very hard problem. This is a very simple problem. So how will you solve the problem?
So string 1 এর ইনিশিয়ালটা string 2 তে সার্চ করা হবে ফারস্টে, তো দেন সেকেন্ড এর যে সেকেন্ড ডিজিটটা যদি string 2 তে মানে একবারই নেক্সটে না থাকে, তো string 2 এর যে একটা কাউন্টার লাগানো থাকবে সেই কাউন্টারটা ইনক্রিজ মানে করা যেতে পারে, তো পরের যাতে লেট মানে একদম কিছু মানে কিছু লেটার বাদে কিছু লেটার কিছু অ্যালফাবেট বাদে যেন ওই লেটারটা আবার আসে, তো ওটা এলে আবার দুটো কি মানে ওখানে আই এর ভ্যালুটাকে স্ট্রিং ওয়ানের যে প্রথম আই এর ভ্যালু আছে ওটাকেও কাউন্ট প্লাস করা যেতে পারে, আর সেকেন্ড স্ট্রিং টু তে ওটাকেও প্লাস করা যেতে পারে, তো
সো দিস ইজ আ ভেরি সিম্পল অ্যালগোরিদম। সো সে মাই অ্যালগোরিদম ইজ এ এ বি এ সি AB, 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 CD, E, AB. This is the string 2. I have to search whether string 1 is present in string 2 or not. How will I start? So I will start comparing these two characters. These two are same. If these two are same, then I will compare the next character. Then it doesn't match. So we can't find the string 1 starting at this position. So if there is any failure in the next step or in upcoming steps, then what we have to decide? Okay, let us start searching operation again But now I will start searching from the second position. Okay, so AA, it matches. Then I will compare two characters, next two characters, it matches. Then I will compare next two, again it matches. Now I will compare these two, but it fails. Okay, if it fails, then I have to restart the operation. Now in second string I will start it from position 3. Okay, so here I will start searching from position 3. So now I will search this two, it doesn't match, so it will fail again. Now I will start first character with the next character, this one, it matches. Then the next one, that means B and C will be compared, it fails. So we have to backtrack. Now we will start comparing A with C, it doesn't match. Then in the next step we will compare A and next A from the string 2. So let me erase because the things are becoming very noisy. So in the next step, which one I will choose? So now in the next step I will compare this A with this A. It does a match. Then next two match, next two match, then it matches. Then when I'm coming here, then it doesn't match. If it doesn't match, again I have to backtrack to the beginning and let me compare it with the next character. So in the next step, the next character means I'll start comparing with this one. So now A will be compared with, the A will be compared with the next character. It doesn't match. So in the next iteration, A will be compared with this A. Okay, now I'll just erase my screen so that I can do the things. So now this A is being compared with this A, then B is being compared with B, next character is being compared with next character with next character, next character, next, next. There is no more element here. So we have found a matching. So now we have decided when we reach at the end of string 1, then we will decide that yes, string 1 is present in string 2. Okay, this is the simplest algorithm. So this algorithm is basically known as naive method. This is naive method. This is the simplest algorithm by which we can find such a string in another string. Okay, now what is the complexity of this algorithm? What will be the complexity of the algorithm? So if the length of the string 1 is m and length of string 2 is n, then how many comparisons are required in worst case scenario?
Big O of n.
Yeah, so it will be big O of mn. If m and, so it will be big O of mn. We can calculate the exact number of iteration or comparison required, but it will be big O of, in the form of big O of mn. Okay, if it is in the form of big O of mn, so the algorithm is fine, but there are two different algorithms which has been developed. One of these algorithms has been developed by Knuth, Morris and Pratt. So the algorithm is named according to their name. So the algorithm is known as KMP algorithm. Okay, so this is a naive method. So we will discuss KMP algorithm. So the KMP, this name comes from their from the name of the developer or the scientist. Okay, Knut, Morris and Pat. So according to their name, it has been named. Okay, so using KMC algorithm, in big of n time, the problem can be solved. So basically the complexity of the algorithm is big of m plus n. Here it is being in the form of m into n, and in KMP algorithm, one pre-processing step is included. Now if we want to solve the problem, then the problem is solvable in m plus n time. Now instead of this, both of this function is polynomial function, but this one is m into n and another one is m plus n. So it's a straight line. So complexity is significantly less compared to the naive method in case of large size of string 1 and string 2. So we will discuss the KMP algorithm. So the purpose of KMP algorithm is searching a string in another string. But just try to understand the theoretical aspect, but in longest common subsequence, if we want to find the longest common subsequence, this is a different problem. It's a string matching problem again, but we are not going to find the exact matching of the string. In longest common subsequence, we are not going to find the exact matching. But in case of string matching, we are going to find the exact matching, whether string 1 is present in string 2 or not. But in longest common subsequence, instead of finding the exact matching, we are trying to find the maximum similarity between two strings. Okay, so we are trying to find maximum similarity. You have to calculate the percentile of similarity, okay, or percentage of similarity between two strings. Now you may think that if I use Control F on a text editor, then I can search a string. So obviously, for this string, searching a string in another string, we are using either naive method or KMP method. Obviously, we will prefer KMP algorithm. But in case of this maximum matching or longest, you have to find longest common subsequence. So if multiple strings are given or two strings are given, you have to find longest common subsequence. Okay? So that indicates that maximum matching between these two strings, but it's not exact matching. So what's that? What will be the application of it? The application of this algorithm is basically, one of the major application of this algorithm is genetics. If we collect gene sample of 2 persons and we want to find the matching of the gene. A gene can be represented as a string. So if we have 2 different genes, now we want to find the maximum matching between these genes. I think all of you are familiar with the gene structure. So basically it's a protein structure. So if we have protein structure for one gene, so it which is being represented as a string, and we have another gene which is another string, so we have to find maximum matching between these two genes. So this is one of the major application of this longest common subsequence. But there are many other applications. I will discuss it later on when we will discuss applications of different algorithm in different aspects in our real life or in computing world. Okay. So just after covering KMP algorithm, we will come to our next point, longest common subsequence. Okay, I will try to cover these 2 topics in next lab. Okay, before that we will get some class. Okay, let us we need basically for longest common subsequence, we need consecutive two classes. So we will try to cover it in upcoming lab. Before that, in the next class, we will be able to cover KNP algorithm. Okay.
Sir, Friday, kon korte korte deben?
কি দিয়েছিলাম বলতো আগের উইকে কি ছিল
আগের উইকে জব সিকোয়েন্সিং করতে দিয়েছিলেন এই শুক্রবার
জব সিকোয়েন্সিং ছিল জাস্ট তোমাদের নেক্সট ক্লাস শুরু হয়ে যাচ্ছে না আচ্ছা তাহলে অ্যাটেন্ডেন্স টাইম নিয়ে যাব তারপর ফুলি ডাউনলোড হয়ে গেছে দেখছি and conquer হয়ে গেছে ডিক্সটপ এলিমেন্ট ফোর হয়ে গেছে ম্যাক্সএক জব সিকোয়েন্সিং উইথ ডেডলাইন কালস হয়ে গেছে ডিএফএস ডিএফএস হয়ে গেছে তাই তো
হ্যাঁ স্যার এগুলো হয়ে গেছে
আচ্ছা ফ্লয়েড ওয়াশেল হ্যাঁ হয়ে গেছে তাহলে গ্রাফ কালারিং
স্যার কোড ফালকারসনটা হয়নি
ফালকারসন মানে নেটওয়ার্ক ফ্লোর জন্য না নেটওয়ার্ক ফ্লো তোমাদের করতে হবে না নেটওয়ার্ক ফ্লো করতে হবে না কিন্তু গ্রাফ কালারিং প্রবলেম তো দিতে পারবো না এখন আমাদের ক্লাসেই হয়নি
গ্রাফ কালারিং থিওরি ক্লাসে হয়ে গিয়েছিল
না না জাস্ট কনসেপ্টটা বলা হয়েছিল গ্রাফ কালারিং প্রবলেম বেশ কমপ্লেক্স প্রবলেম আমরা ডিসকাস করব আমরা ব্যাক ট্র্যাকিং করাই নি এখন ব্যাক ট্র্যাকিং দিয়ে সলভ করতে হবে ওটা তো গ্রিডি অ্যাপ্রোচে ছিল যেখান থেকে আমরা অপটিমাল সলিউশন নাও পেতে পারি অবজেক্টিভ নয় আমাদের অবজেক্টিভ হচ্ছে ইউ হ্যাভ টু ফাইন্ড অপটিমাল সলিউশন এন কুইন প্রবলেম না এটার হচ্ছে নেক্সট দিন কেএমপি না করি আগে তোমাদের ল্যাবটাকে তো কন্টিনিউ করতে হবে ল্যাবের বাকি আদার্স প্রবলেমগুলো সবই আছে হচ্ছে তোমাদের ব্যাক ট্র্যাকিং রিলেটেড সব ব্যাক ট্র্যাকিং রিলেটেড মানে গ্রাফ কালারিং 15 পাজেল ট্রাভেলিং সেলসম্যান প্রবলেম ডাইনামিক প্রোগ্রামিং দিয়ে করাতে হবে এন কুইন আচ্ছা নেক্সট দিন আমি গ্রাফ কালারিং করিয়ে দেবো নেক্সট দিন গ্রাফ কালারিংটা আগে করিয়ে দিই নাহলে ল্যাবটা করতে পারবে না গ্রাফ কালারিং গ্রাফ কালারিং অর এন পয়েন্ট এনি ওয়ান অফ দিস ওকে ফাইন টু মাই জয়েন ইন দ্য নেক্সট ক্লাস আই হ্যাভ টেকেন ইওর অ্যাটেন্ডেন্স ওকে ফাইন Bye.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.